الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى واستعين به واستغفره واستهديه، وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين والآخرين والملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين يا أرحم الراحمين. في حديث في صحيح ابن ماجة، الحديث صححه الشيخ الألباني سفنتك حديث، عن زيد بن ثابت قال: سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول: من كانت الدنيا همه فرق الله عليه أمره. Let's try to understand this حديث. وجعل فقره بين عينيه ولم يأته من الدنيا إلا ما كتب له. يبقى عندنا one thing، من كانت الدنيا همه، number one فرق الله عليه أمره، two وجعل فقره بين عينيه، three ولم يأته من الدنيا إلا ما كتب له. طيب second person، ومن كانت الآخرة نيته جمع الله له أمره أبزت سبحان الله، وجعل غناه في قلبه وأتته الدنيا وهي راغمة. The meaning of this hadith, before we explain it, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, which is Zayd ibn Thabit narrated that hadith, it's an authentic hadith. Sheikh al-Albani narrated that hadith also, said it is very authentic, and the Tirmidhi also, Imam al-Tirmidhi, wa sahih al-Albani fi al-salsala al-sahih. Bas al-Albani, rahimahullah, qal sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, an Anas ibn Malik, this narration by Anas, man kanat al-akhiratu hammahu, جعل الله غناه في قلبه وجمع له شمله وأتته الدنيا وهي راغمة، ومن كانت الدنيا همه جعل الله فقره بين عينيه وفرق عليه شمله ولم يأته من الدنيا إلا ما قدر له. Same meaning but حديث معاذ ابن حديث زيد بن ثابت، he put in the حديث الدنيا before الآخرة، but حديث أنس narrated by الإمام الترمذي he put الآخرة before الدنيا. It's the same meaning exactly. But look at the meaning of this حديث. Zayd ibn Thabit reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace and the blessing be upon him, said, whoever, look at the meaning, whoever is concerned about this world of life, this dunya, Allah will disorder his affairs, make him fear poverty, and he will not get anything of this dunya world except that which has been decreed for him. This is first person. And whoever is concerned about the hereafter, al-akhirah, Allah will settle his affairs, mashallah. Allah will make him content in his heart. يجعل غناه في قلبه. And the world will automatically come to him, subhanallah. Allah will bring him everything while he's, mashallah, comfortable. This hadith is telling us too many things here, subhanallah. Those who are seeking dunya, the meaning of the hadith is not to just to give your back to this dunya and to sit home and to sit in the grave and said, khalas, this is the akhir. It's not like that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said also in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Qasas, ولا تنسى نصيبك من الدنيا. Don't forget about your portion of this dunya. But look what he said, وأحسن كما أحسن الله إليك. Be good the way Allah was good to you, is good to you. Allah, وَهَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. Yes, it's, mashallah, if you make good, Allah will bring you good. It's subhanallah. But that's why the meaning of this hadith, you have to balance between the dunya and the akhirah. And don't make the dunya your mission, your final mission or target or final destination. The meaning of this hadith is to balance. You have to balance between the dunya. Because some people, like what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they concern only about the dunya. Dunya his ham, his mission. Khalas, in dunya he gonna live in dunya. He think he gonna live in this world of life as if forever he gonna live. فرق الله عليه أمره. He's working a lot. He's trying to collect from right and left. Subhanallah. This everything will be disorder. You know, he cannot just working a lot for nothing. فرق الله عليه أمره. And Allah will make his poverty between his eyes. He's running, working 24/7, but he's still poor. Why? Because the dunya is his mission. This is the meaning of the hadith. ولم يأتيه من الدنيا إلا ما كتب له. Whatever is written for him, this is what he's gonna get. If he worked 24/7, سبحان الله. Sometimes you see some people, سبحان الله, they have millions of dollars. Millions of dollars, والله, سبحان الله. Whenever you sit with them, brother, how are you? والله, it's وكل هوا. It's miserable life, brother. I'm not happy. You have all of these millions, all of these properties, all of this dunya, and you never say, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. Why? My life is not good. I'm not happy, brother. I'm not happy. A lot of depression. Life is sucks. Ta'ban. I'm not. Subhanallah. This is what this is the way, subhanallah. And his life just count dollars, dirahim, and he doesn't care about his salah. He doesn't care about the masjid. He doesn't care about salat al-arham, his kinship, subhanallah. He just has the fear of his money will be minus. All will be eliminated to a certain amount. This is his mission. That's it. Subhanallah, these people, they have no balance. And even while Allah is giving him all of this, he never gave Allah's rights. What is Allah's rights in his money? Zakah. To give zakah and charity. Subhanallah, these people, they never say Alhamdulillah. His concern is just about the dunya. This is the meaning of the hadith. His concern is just about the dunya. That's it. This is what al-hadith is talking about. Subhanallah. His night and his day is just counting money. How much I make, how much I lose. How much I make, how much I lose. I lose. Subhanallah. And this man, he lives in humoom, waghumoom, grief and sadness. Imagine if he loses some business or lose something, oh, he can sleep all night. Subhanallah. Why? Because he fear from the future. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make this man, even if he has millions of dollars or money, his poverty between his eyes. And subhanallah, well, he's still counting a lot of money, and he never say Alhamdulillah. Just this is his mission. This is exactly the hadith talking about this people. What gonna happen to him? This person, subhanallah, Allah will make his poverty between his eyes. He will never say Alhamdulillah. He will never be satisfied and content. That's why Allah told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Allah will give you a Muhammad until you will be satisfied. Does not mean Allah will make towers for Rasulullah, this dunya. No. With little كان عايش النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كفاف. كفاف means there is no extra. Whatever satisfied him, this is فترضى. قال الحمد لله. وإلى الله سبحانه وتعالى offered him. Said, يا محمد, if you want the mountains of Mecca to be gold for you, I will make it for you gold. Did you see the mountains of Mecca? سبحان الله, rocks. Very strong rocks. If I want to tear this gold for you, I will make it for you. He said, no, يا رب. No. I want you just to live like a Nabi and Abd. If I'm hungry one day, I will ask you. If you will be satisfied, I will be thankful to you. That's it. طب, you want to live forever? No. I don't want to live forever. بل الرفيق الأعلى. Yeah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ولا الآخرة خير لك من الأول. Already Allah told him that. الآخرة is better for. And the الآخرة does not mean the hereafter. Some tafsir, they said الآخرة, the end of everything will be better than the beginning. Exactly. This is the meaning of ولا الآخرة. Yeah. See, Rasulullah, his Sahaba, they've been tortured in Mecca, and what happened to the end? MashaAllah, Rasulullah, Medina, the Sahaba, and all of that. You know, the end of everything will be better than the beginning of it. And when he is concerned about al-akhirah with little work, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him his rizq and barakah in it too. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it for him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يعني, will settle everything for him. That's it, subhanAllah. Allah will manage his life. And also, not just that, he will be content in his heart. He will be happy. And the dunya, automatically, by the order of Allah, it will come to him. Dunya will run behind him. Allah will give him without any tiredness, without too much work. That's why you see too many people, they are not coming to the masjid. Do you know why? Because their mission is the dunya. They are 24/7 running. That's why you not see them. Believe me, if they have time, they will come. But they don't have time. They're working too much work. There is a disorder there. Allah did not settle their affairs, because I read that hadith and I love it so much. بقول لك الناس في مساجدهم والله في قضاء حوائجهم. I believe that 100%. People are sitting in their masajid for salah and the prayer and zikr, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking care of their affairs and business outside. Believe me, wallahi. Whenever you have some time, this is zakah of your time. When you come to the masjid, you make some zikr or salah, this is zakah of your time. Zakah of your knowledge, of your health. Why? Because you give it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, you cut yourself out from the dunya and you stay in the masjid for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will give you the reward. The main thing, or the main point of this hadith today, سبحان الله, your mission must be الآخرة, the hereafter. Work for it hard, because this is your final destination, and this is eternity, the life of eternity. الجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض عدة المتقين. الدنيا, more you engage yourself with the dunya, will be occupied with the dunya, ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said التكاثر is not bad, to be rich or to have money is not bad, but the problem is first word in the ayah, ألهاكم. See, this is what the scholar of tafsir saying. You understand the Quran, you get it. Allah said ألهاكم التكاثر, you've been occupied by too much money, wealthy money, children, تكاثر, too much. التكاثر is to have much money or children or whatever, knowledge and power, that's good in Islam. المؤمن القوي خير ومحب الله من المؤمن الضعيف. The strong and mu'min in everything is better than the weak one. But the problem of our life, ألهاكم, you've been occupied with this. Don't be occupied. Put the dunya in your hand and the akhirah in your heart. And let your hand and the dunya work for the akhirah. ومن أراد الآخرة وسعى لها سعيها وهو مؤمن فأولئك كان سعيهم مشكور. Yes. الآية اللي قبلها إيه؟ من كان يريد الدنيا فكذا, الله سكر بوت الدنيا, من كان يريد الحياة العاجلة وكذا something, عجلنا له فيها ما نشاء لمن نريد ثم جعلنا له جهنم مصرا. If somebody's mission is الدنيا, I will give you الدنيا, but جهنم is waiting for him because he forget the rights of Allah. But the one who is looking for الآخرة and he's working for it, وسعى لها, سعى means he would work, it is not just by تمني, false hope. Yes, Allah ghafur rahim, brother, it's okay, I'm not praying, I'm not giving anything, this is done, this is all fake. If you want to really love Allah and you want to work for Allah, work, show, make sa'i, make action. وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا with iman, while he's believing in the oneness of Allah. فَأُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُمْ. Allah is very grateful to you, appreciative. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمٌ. صح, Allah شاكر, Allah شكور. شكور means Allah is very appreciative to you. Whenever you make something good, Allah will appreciate that. And Allah, how is his appreciation? With the reward, with Jannah is waiting for you. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabb, أن يجعلنا وإياكم من طلاب الآخرة وليس طلاب الدنيا, وأن يجعلنا نسعى للآخرة يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى يا رب العالمين. اللهم ثبتنا على الهدى وعلى الإيمان وعلى الطريق المستقيم يا رب العالمين. يسر أمورنا, يمن كتابنا, واحفظنا جميعا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعلى أيماننا وعن شمائلنا, وجعلنا لك من الشاكرين يا ربنا. اشف مرضانا جميعا ومرضى المسلمين, واشف من كان منا مريضا يا رب العالمين. واغفر لنا ولآبائنا ولأمهاتنا كما ربيانا صغيرا يا أرحم الراحمين. نسألك يا ربنا من الخير كله عاجله وآجله, ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله. نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل, ونعوذ بك من النار ومن عذاب النار ومن خزي النار ومن كل قول وعمل يقربنا إلى النار يا أرحم الراحمين. يا ربنا اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار, وصلى اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.